when the NPC made the decision, the State Department spokesperson of the United States condemned such a step as serious damage to the democratic system in Hong Kong, and what will be the Chinese government's response to the sanctions by the Western countries?
First, I would like to point out that how will the electoral system of the Hong Kong SAR be designed and improved? This is purely China's internal affairs, and no foreign country has the right to make any irresponsible comments. As far as I know, the United States itself has very strict laws and regulations against foreign interference in their elections. Well, recently, the U.S. House of Representatives just adopted a bill on safeguarding its election security. So this begs the question, why is it that the United States can amend its election, and why the U.S. gets so jittery and nervous about the amendment of legislation of a local administrative region of China and tries to interfere in this process? Back in 2019, during the turbulence over the amendment bill in Hong Kong, where rioters resorted to violence and stormed the Legislative Council. You may all recall that some American politicians got quite excited, and they call this a beautiful sight to behold. Yet in January this year, when the American demonstrators stormed the Capitol, they defined this incident as domestic terrorism. Well, this is typical, frequent double standards. Last year, the U.S. presidential election has been surrounded with so much chaos, and in January, the U.S. Capitol was stormed violently. I don't know, after all this turbulence in the United States, how has the U.S. has any right to point fingers at China's domestic affairs and the democratic institution of Hong Kong? As we all know, at the 46th session of the Human Rights Council, representatives of 70 countries co-signed a statement urging relevant parties to stop meddling in Hong Kong affairs and China's internal affairs. Well, this fully demonstrates that hegemonism enjoys no support. As for the sanctions the United States so often slaps on other countries, well, it has long been despised by people around the world. Many of my colleagues at the Hong Kong and Macau Affairs Office, including Mr. Xia Baolong, Mr. Deng Zhonghua, and I myself, were listed last year for sanctions by the U.S. government. Well, actually, we wear it as a badge of honor. But in response to such sanctions, we always follow the principle of reciprocity. And our countermeasures will certainly teach them a lesson. Thank you.